Welcome, you are listening Radio Central News. I'm Chandni, and now news in detail.
Amid the ongoing high-level military talks between two nations, the Indian Army on Saturday said the officials of India and China would engage through established military and diplomatic channels to address the current situation in the border areas of eastern Ladakh. The crucial military talks at Lieutenant General level between India and China began on Saturday to resolve over a month-long stalemate at the borders in eastern Ladakh. The meeting being held at Moldo Meeting Point on Chinese side was being led by 14 Corps Commander Lieutenant General Harinder Singh on Indian side, while the Chinese side of the delegation was represented by South Xinjiang Military Division Corps Commander Major General Lin Liu. On Friday, the joint secretary-level diplomatic talks were held between two neighboring nations. Ministry of External Affairs said in a statement that both the sides agreed in accordance with the guidance provided by their leadership and they should handle their differences through peaceful discussion, bearing in mind the importance of respecting each other's sensitivities, concerns, and aspirations and not allowing them to become disputes. India went past Italy to become the sixth worst hit nation by the COVID-19 pandemic, with the country registering a record single-day spike of 9,887 cases, which pushed the nationwide tally to 2,36,657. India's death toll due to the COVID-19 rose to 6,642, with a record increase of 294 deaths in the 24 hours till Saturday 8 a.m. India has registered over 9,000 cases for the third day in a row. Of the 294 deaths reported since Friday morning, 139 were in Maharashtra, 58 in Delhi, 35 in Gujarat, 12 each in Tamil Nadu and Uttar Pradesh, 11 in West Bengal, 8 in Telangana, 7 in Madhya Pradesh, 5 in Rajasthan, 2 in Andhra Pradesh and 1 each in Jammu and Kashmir, Odisha, Punjab, Jharkhand and Uttarakhand. Of the total 6,642 fatalities, Maharashtra topped Delhi with 2,849 deaths, followed by Gujarat with 1,190 deaths, Delhi with 708, Madhya Pradesh with 384, West Bengal with 366, Uttar Pradesh with 257, Tamil Nadu with 232, Rajasthan with 218, Telangana with 113, and Andhra Pradesh with 73 deaths. The death toll reached 57 in Karnataka and 48 in Punjab. Jammu and Kashmir has reported 36 fatalities due to the disease. Bihar has 29, Haryana has 24 deaths, Kerala has 14, Uttarakhand has 11, Odisha has 8, and Jharkhand has reported 7 deaths so far. Himachal Pradesh and Chandigarh have registered 5 COVID-19 fatalities. Each Assam have recorded 4 deaths, while Chhattisgarh has reported 2 deaths so far.
In the first such instance in West Bengal, two judges of the city court have tested positive for COVID-19, following which people who had come in contact with them have been advised to proceed on home quarantine. The two affected are judges of the District Civil and Session Court in Alipur and are being treated at private medical establishment here. There are 4,025 active cases of the contagion in West Bengal so far, while the number of confirmed cases are 7,303. At least 294 people have succumbed to the disease, while 72 others have died due to comorbidities where COVID-19 was incidental. Former Indian cricketer Sachin Tendulkar shared a video posted by International Cricket Council earlier this week to show support to the ongoing movement against racism. ICC released the video in the wake of George Floyd's death in the US, which has sparked huge protest in the country. Tendulkar, sharing the video on his official Twitter profile, quoted former South African President Nelson Mandela that sport has the power to change the world. It has the power to unite the world in a way that little else does. Earlier, many athletes have also voiced the outrage over the death of Floyd's. Cricketer like Chris Gayle and Andre Russell took in their official Instagram profile to speak on the Black Lives Matter movement. Former West Indies captain Darren Sammy too penned a message on his official Twitter profile urging people to come together for justice. Among other sports, tennis players like Serena Williams and Coco Gauff, basketball legend Michael Jordan, boxing star Floyd Mayweather, Manchester United football Marcus Rashford and Formula One driver Lewis Hamilton are among the many athletes who have spoken on racism amid the movement. That is all for the today's news bulletin. Stay tuned to Radio Centre News for more updates.